Good morning, welcome to Morning Outlook. This is Kim speaking on Wednesday the 19th of February. So looking at the euro dollar first, and well, it sold off once again yesterday, pretty much through the day there, not really looking back too much. Had a moment when it caught the weekly S1, but from then onwards it came back down and sold off. So where to at the moment? Well, there's still a divergence sitting across the lows here. But none of this is being triggered. Every time it sort of looks a bit divergency, we don't see a break of the trigger point of it for as a standard RSI sort of take. I know this is a MACD at the bottom there, but in terms of Wilder's RSI rules of divergences, it certainly doesn't fit that. So at the moment, still looking really quite bearish. Now short term, it's just a little put this hourly time frame, it's just put a higher low in, may have some more upside. Daily pivot's still above there at 80.06, or 80.06 even. We could start pushing up at some stage, but it is very, very slow, and it seems that generally, even though there was good news out yesterday, it seems to let it go quite quickly, and well, may take a while for that to push through. I think so long as there's so many longs on a lot of these brokers and the long positions sitting out there, the markets are going the other way at the moment, at least. Nothing set up there for me in those time frames on the euro, I should say. The pound, gradually, just chopping along, really. I'm saying gradually, but It looks like at stages it's trying to push up there, but it's a difficult one to read at the moment. And where's this going at the moment? We'll see. I'll just put that trend line across there. So at the moment it's really in a downward trend, but in between all that, it's having some half decent moves at times. I mean, yesterday morning was an example where it absolutely looked like it was going to push on through towards the R1 at one stage, but it just got choked back into. I've moved this to the trend line here, but if I put the trend line back in about there, it's just getting choked on this sort of level here, the horizontal sort of level of just there's obviously selling coming in at 30.50-ish. As it sits at the moment, it's to put a bullish pivot swing in here on the, so there's a little signal that might come to something. It really needs to break the high of this bar, the 7 o'clock bar. If it starts pushing up there, well, it could have some further upside. Where to? Maybe up to yesterday's highs. At some point it may break that. I mean, you can see there's a level across the highs there. There's a zone up there as well, as I would call it, where you sort of you've got plenty of supply, but a break point past this point here, as I say, maybe this the trigger for further upside on the pound. Is holding up half decently, mostly, but does hand it back quite quickly as well, I guess. Dollar yen, well, softening this morning, pushing through back up to this sort of level that we've seen over the last last week, whether it can break through this point now, we'll see, but it is one of the softer currencies on my list, and fundamentally I was looking to see if there's any divergence at these highs, no real divergence, but it has retraced a bit off this second high there, maybe a bit of RSI divergence kicking through there. It's pretty much untradeable for the most of the day. It tends to sit there in tight old ranges for long periods. It's great if you're looking for a breakout trade, but you have to be around pretty late. It was at midnight, 11 o'clock last night when it started this push up here. But for large points of the day, it becomes range bound, so untradeable. I will look at the Aussie dollar today. It's going down into this point where there's obviously some sort of demand down this area here, but well, we'll see how much. But overall, it does still look weak, and maybe today a break of its trend line may see it come back down towards the weekly S1 there, prior lows. It does look soft and shorter term frame here. Well, we've got higher lows, higher highs coming through here, so maybe a little bit more bullish. But as I say, I'd only be looking on the sell side potentially if it broke the trend line there. But for now, it's just about holding up, but looking like it may roll. Right, no point looking at any of those others. That's it for me. Because I'm not going to be trading any of the others. So that's where we are there. News-wise today, we've got the some pound news this morning, 9:30. We've got inflation data coming out, expected to come in, and the forecast at 1.6%, and the CPI there. So may get a bit of volatility around that, depending on what it comes out. The Canadian data is also out today, inflation at 1:30. So may get a bit of volatility later on that. And FOMC minutes later at 7 p.m. Now these used to create quite a bit of some volatility, some decent volatility sometimes. May just give us a move, but I think after seeing last meeting data, etc., I don't think there's going to be a lot there to drive us anyway. So maybe worth one just forgetting about, but we'll see. Okay, that's it for me. Have a great day. Bye for now.